Greetings and welcome to the Monday Club, the world famous platform for watercolour expertise. Tony here, hope you're all well, desperate for your next workout. Now I've been asked to do an impressionist subject, or maybe figures. Here we've got both covered. This is Monet's fabulous Woman with Parasol. Now, Monet did more than one of these. He is Monet's wife, Madame Monet, and her son. And this is another one. This is the woman, I think it's the woman facing left with Parasol. Now, I copied this a few years ago. This was my attempt. So I thought I'd try and replicate this and we can do it together. It's not too difficult, I hope. So keep that in mind. Let's pop you here. Now I've already penciled this in. It's a portrait configuration, so I can keep that to the left and you can see more of my palette. Oh joy. Right. Let's go back. I want to talk this through. So, first of all, we'll do a fairly busy sky, but in cerulean blue, which is a bit paler than this. Plenty of cloud action in the background. Let's just go back to Monet. And well, we can't compete with that, can we? But there's plenty of colour. And how he's got a figure against the bright sky and not in complete shadow, it's just amazing. So there's so much light there, really is fabulous. I think ours will have a bit more contrast than that. So this is ours. Yeah, I'll paint it around this, paint the sky around the figure, although a lot of it is in dark contrast, so I could just paint over the sky, because I want to maintain this glowing parasol, and the sides of the dress down there also want to be nice and bright. And the foreground is flowers and a bit of shadow there. Okay, let's go back again. Oh, it's a delicate operation this. Right, we've used 4 minutes up of our 30 already. So as before, I'll keep stopping to preserve time. Clear this space. Oh dear, it's a dirty brush. Should have cleaned this before now. Oops, it's come off again. Right. Are we ready? Right. Cerulean blue. Not a strong blue. It's not like French ultramarine, which is much stronger than this. water. Right, we should have enough there. So let's paint this on. I think I can paint over the scarf and the arm. In fact, I can paint over most of this. Okay, so I've been a bit deliberately clumsy and messy with the sky. I'd like to capitalize on that. Going to bring in a bit of ultramarine. Mainly because it's my favourite colour. I think that's fine. It's a weird sky, but there's impressionists when all said and done. So mess that up a bit. Okay. Gonna let that dry. Okay, so I've darkened the sky a bit and I've added a tiny bit of raw sienna. Splash it on here and there. So now I'm gonna do the parasol in a cadmium lemon. I'm just gonna go right through with that. And I'm going to do the dress in a rose and madder. I'll dry that so it doesn't bleed too much. Just take that through. That will be like an undercoat for the dress. Oops. Sorry, madam. Take out a little bit of colour from that region. Okay, let that dry. So I've dried that. Now I'm going to wet it again. Blue, fairly strong blue, old and Wet in Wet Magic. It's not the rain. So I'm just following the lines of the spokes with the parasol a little bit. Come back to that. Now the dress. I'll try a bit of violet in the shaded part. Mix it with the rose madder. Preserving this arm because it's probably darker. Not yet. Bit of care about the figure. Would be a good idea to practice drawing this figure because it's got to look right. It's got to look upright. Slightly braced against the wind and the arms in the right positions. Especially the arm with the umbrella. A little bit tricky that practice. A smaller brush for this. This is shade. Bit of water. So we've got two colours there, there's rose madder and violet. Push that out. You're wearing a bonnet, which is quite pale in Monet's. I'm going to do a darker one. What colour? go blue again. Ultramarine. I don't really know what bonnets look like. This is the shape stuck on her head. But then it's a curious thing, there's a scarf as well. I'm gonna two-tone that. I don't know why. The scarf comes under her chin and zooms off into space. It'll be quite pale out there in the sunlight. Slightly dark element. Like that. Skin tone. Burnt sienna is always good. Still damp, just create the highlight with a dry brush. Sure that's dry. So this arm is very much in shadow. Like I say, practice drawing this on a scrap piece of paper before you commit. So there's a fingers bunched around the umbrella and a thumb is on the other side. That looks rather odd, but when the umbrella comes along, I'm hoping it looks a lot better. So here comes the umbrella. Ooh. Right, some umbrella spokes now. So it starts from there. Now we're doing 20 minutes, so I've got 10 minutes. Turn that down a bit. Face. Paint burnt sienna again. Quite pale. Now, at this stage, you just need a hint of facial features. So, I'm watching this dry slightly. In the meantime, just add a bit here and there. To the face, bit of sepia, let's see what happens. Nothing, great. Still a bit damp. Okay. I'm blowing it. Right. She looks a bit like a Neanderthal, unfortunately. Sorry, madam. Come back to that because we've only got 8 minutes left. I'm going to put the foreground in, create a really pale background, bigger brush. That's more like it. Dark colours, some reds. Some yellow. watercolours. Reinforce the shadow area. Back to the dress, which is dry now, so I can put some creases in it. Underneath the dress will be dark, not too much. Right, not long left now, so I'm going to turn the camera off for a couple of minutes. I'm going to sort that face out and one or two highlights here and there. So while you were away, I dumbed the face down a bit. A bit more vagueness there. It looks okay. Sorted the arms out simply by removing a bit of paint here and there. Skin tone looks okay now. So, nearly done now, for a quick job, it's not so bad, light looks alright. Can't really see that as I've got the camera. Anyway, I can see it. It looks okay. Still got a couple of minutes left. Oh, there's one thing I could do. The original had the sunlight catching the parasol. So, just a hint of gouache. Do the trick. A little bit more, I think. Okay. Any more gouache, anyone? No. Okay. 30 minutes. I'll have to go before we get cut off. How does that look? Our impressionist lady with the parasol. Well, the colours are good. So I'm going to mess with it. I think that's a bit more shade there. Yeah. No, it's getting worse. Stop. All done. Hope you enjoyed that. And I'll see you next week. Bye now.